I'm Dr. Penisha. I'm going to handle electromagnetic fields of second year, fourth semester. So here I have prescribed two books. One is Cheng Field and next one is Buck, his engineering electromagnetic book. So these are the two books I'm using, I'm preferring for this electromagnetic fields. And this is the syllabus. In the first unit, we will be seeing the basics of electromagnetic field, and the second unit will be studying about electric field, third unit about magnetic field, and fourth unit about Maxwell equation, and in the fifth unit we'll be discussing about the waves, electromagnetic waves. So in the first unit we'll be discussing about the electromagnetic model and about scalars, vectors, how to represent a vector and coordinate systems, then line surface and volume integrals and vector operators, that is divergence, gradient, curl, then about some theorems. So first is electromagnetic field. What is electromagnetic field? So electromagnetic field is nothing but it is the study of both electric as well as magnetic field. Both electric and magnetic field combined as electromagnetic field. They are closely related to each other. First of all, what is field? So field is nothing but if you consider it is a region. So if you are considering two magnets, means if the two magnets are combined to each other, then there occurs some kind of physical function. So that kind of physical function occurs at the field at each and every point. Okay, if it is based on the magnetic effects, means if that physical function is based on magnetic effects, means it is called magnetic field, and if it is because of electric effects, means it is called electric field. So the study of both electric and magnetic fields is called electromagnetic fields. So here based on that electric field and magnetic field, that is electric field is produced by the presence of electrically charged particles and magnetic field is present by the magnetic effects. So both combination is called as electromagnetic field. So here next we are discussing about scalars and vectors. So scalars represented by the magnitude and vectors are represented by both magnitude and direction. So in the case of scalar, means examples are there: temperature, mass, volume, density, speed. In case of vectors, force, velocity, displacement, acceleration, these are the vectors. So scalar field means it is nothing but in a field, if some kind of physical action is occurring, so that kind of physical action occurred at each and every point are specified by a real number. In the case of vector field, that physical function of that physical value, each point of the physical value will be represented by the magnitude as well as direction. And here, how to represent a vector? So in the case of representing a vector, we know that to represent a vector, it indicates a line with the arrow mark. So starting point will be, if the line is starting from the O to A, then O is called as the starting point and A is called as the terminating point, and its magnitude is denoted by R vector. So vector will be always denoted as from the starting point to terminate point, that we have to write it, and we have to put a direction also in the case of vector, since it denotes the magnitude as well as direction. In case of magnitude, we have to write just about the starting point and the terminal point. So you have to denote it by mod symbol. And in case of unit vector, so unit vector means the unit vector will indicate only the direction. So its magnitude will always be unity. So it is denoted as OA A vector is equal to OA vector divided by mod OA vector. Okay. Then vector algebra. So in here we are going to discuss about scaling, vector addition, vector subtraction, vector multiplication. So first of all, what is scaling? Scaling is nothing but it is a multiplication of a vector with the scalar. So here three conditions are given. If alpha value is greater than 1, what are the possibilities? So here we know that we are multiplying a vector with the scalar. So if alpha is a scalar, if alpha value is 5, means it is multiplied with the scalar quantity, then direction will be remain same, but its magnitude will be different because it is greater than 1, and if it is less than 1 means it denotes point value. So if it is multiplied with the scalar, vector is multiplied with the scalar means then the direction will be same but the magnitude will be less. But in case of alpha is equal to minus 1, if that condition, the direction will be reversed because it indicates negative direction. And in vector addition, there is we are using parallelogram rule. So considering two vectors, A vector, B vector, and here two steps are noted. That is, first we are moving the OA vector, that is A vector, like that we are moving the parallel to the other side, and then we are joining the two vectors. From that we are finding the resultant value. So the resultant value is equal to addition of other two sides, A vector plus B vector. And in the case of four vectors means the resultant value will be the addition of other four sides. So this is parallelogram law. Here commutative law, associative law, distributive law in case of addition and multiplication is discussed. So in the case of vector subtraction, the same rule is applied as in the vector addition, but here we are using negative direction, so that in the case of B vector we are using minus B vector. So while resultant will be equal to C vector equal to A vector minus B vector. So identical vectors means then if A vector and B vector are equal, that is identical vectors. So next one is vector, before going to vector multiplication, we have to know about what is member coordinate system, because if coordinate system is known, then it will be easy to know about vector product. So coordinate systems, here three types of coordinate system is there. One is Cartesian coordinate system, second one is cylindrical coordinate system, and third one is spherical coordinate system. So in the case of Cartesian coordinate system, three coordinates are there, x, y and z. So this determines, here two systems are there, right-handed system, left-handed system. Here the difference is, in Cartesian coordinate system we are using x, y and z as the coordinate, and in the case of the cylindrical coordinate system we are using r, phi and z, and in the case of spherical coordinate system we are using r, theta and phi as the coordinates. So here next we are representing the point P in a Cartesian coordinate system. To denote the point P, we have to know that the three axes lies in the same point, so that is considered as the common point, that is P point. So from that we are finding the coordinates. If the value is given, we have to find the region where it is present. And next one is base vector. Base vector is also called as a unit vector. So based on the, we have, before finding a unit vectors, we must know position vectors and the magnitude of it. So to calculate the unit vectors, we have to first calculate the position distance vectors as well as the magnitude. From that we will be calculating the unit vectors. In case of, if two points are given means we have to find the region, that is, for if a PQ means, then we have to find as terminating point minus starting point. First we have to find out the direction of the distance vector, so that the starting point and the ending point we will be knowing. Then we have to subtract those coordinates of the starting point from the terminating point, so that from that we have to add these three components and we have to find out the magnitude. From the magnitude and this position vector, we will be finding out the unit vectors. So based on that, one problem is discussed here. And next one is differential elements. So differential elements of the coordinate system, we know differential is indicated by dy by dx. So here dl by dx is the, dl is the common point. So the dx, dy, dz are indicate the differential length in the x, y, z direction. So from that we are calculating the magnitude and the differential volume and differential surface. So based on that, two problems are discussed. And in the cylindrical coordinate system, as I said, here the coordinates are r, pi and z. So here the values are ranges from 0, r value ranges from 0 to infinity, pi value ranges from 0 to 2 pi, and the z value ranges from minus infinity to infinity. So for here, if one of the coordinates is 0 means then which plane it represents? The two dimensional plane, so it is represented here. And in the cylindrical format, it is represented, the point P is represented in the cylindrical format by considering the xz plane, xy plane and yz plane. So base vector is the unit vectors. So here, based on the coordinates r, pi and z, we are calculating the position and the as well as the magnitude. So differential elements is also discussed in the same way as in the Cartesian coordinate system. Here also magnitude as well as differential volume and the surface is calculated for each point. So differential surface area for the coordinates r, theta, pi is calculated. Based on that, here we are calculating the magnitude as well as the unit vectors. And the relationship between the Cartesian and the coordinate system is, here Cartesian coordinate system we are using x, y, z as the coordinates, and in the cylindrical coordinate system we are using r, pi and z. So we are mashing both and we'll be finding the cos factor, pi, sine factor, and also the that is, we'll be calculating the pi value. In order to find the pi value, we are calculating these values. So x equal to r cos pi, y equal to r sin pi, z equal, since z lies in the same plane, it is denoted as z. Cos pi is denoted as adjacent by hypotenuse, and sin pi is denoted by opposite by hypotenuse. So based on that trigonometric ratios, we are calculating the pi value. So with that, one problem is discussed here. And next one is spherical coordinate system. In spherical coordinate system, the values lie between 0 to infinity and 0 to 2 pi. Pi ranges from 0 to 2 pi and theta ranges from 0 to pi. So here, point P is represented in the format of spherical coordinate system as shown here. Based on the constant value, if some of the coordinates are 0, then other two-dimensional relationship is given here. And the base vectors is AR vector, A theta and A phi vector. So based on that, base vectors is also denoted, and from the differential elements of is calculated, that is from that magnitude and as well as the differential volume and differential surface is also, we are calculating the differential volume, differential surface value from this coordinates, that is R, theta and pi. Based on this Cartesian and the spherical systems, so here they both are matched and we are getting the pi value. Here also we are finding out the pi value. So based on that, we have seen here three problems.